It was Thanksgiving weekend, 1969, a very difficult time in U.S. history. I was 19 years old, working as a professional photographer in my dad's Palm Beach studio. I was about to board a helicopter for the very first time in my life. I knew where I was going. I just didn't know what to expect. My father and I were headed into a combat zone as the official photographers of what we now call the Palm Beach Pop Festival. Here's the story of that forgotten festival.
People really understand and recognize, and all the street riots as an example of the 60s. They didn't exist, they exist very long, when a show of force was shown to them. And by the same token, this was the case there. And a lot less activity went on because we did show force there. They knew we were there. And they knew we were not only there on ground, but we were there in the vicinity with force.
And of course, the sheriff was the one causing all the trouble. Wanting to shut the thing down without letting it happen, because Woodstock had happened, and now they're thinking all of these awful young people are going to come here, and the Rolling Stones and Janis Joplin, the whole show. And so,
well, most of the churches were against it, and most of the city government, because of the heat from certain people.
The Zoning Commission acted after hearing more than 3 hours of testimony, most of it against the festival. Witness after witness testified the event would turn into an uncontrollable orgy.
Well, the membership to this committee is swelling. We had a meeting in Belglade last night of more than 100 interested and influential citizens, including 30 to 50 ministers.
The opposition was led by the Palm Beach Committee for Decency. Among those testifying for the committee was Mayor Sam Houston of Lewisville, Texas, who described the festival held there last Labor Day as a near tragedy. Houston said his 9-man police force was at the mercy of the more than 100,000 persons in attendance.
You have no control over it. Your community has no control over it, because with such a mass of people and with so few law enforcement officials and officers, you cannot adequately maintain law and order. And of course, the main threat that was hanging over our head was the threat of riot. And at several times we felt that it was imminent, and also felt that we would have probably been close to helpless if such a riot had occurred. And such a riot is possible at these pop festivals.
Jess Moody was basically saying that the Religious Alliance of Churches would get behind it and would get the heat off their back.
My facility is not a pasture and field, which Woodstock and the festivals that they tried to produce in the courtroom were held at. These people did not have competent facilities. They did not have competent security. People were invited to come there and get naked and do all of these obscene things for months and months ahead of time, yet the government entities and the counties and states that they lived in did nothing to stop this type of action. So therefore, I can only say to them, they got what they asked for.
They said, we've got to ask for one thing, no nudity. And I said, well, I don't understand that. And they said, well, we are not going to let our children's minds be hurt by nudity.
Arthur came, crowds were monstrous, was pouring down rain a lot of the time. That was the big problem. That's really what made it a devastating thing financially.
So we were rattled. We were all sort of nervous because of the pressure that was being exerted on the festival personnel by the local police department and the floor politics.
Oh, the weather was, it was cold, it was rainy, muddy, and I mean, everybody was all in there together. And it was just shivering cold at night. And people were, I mean, their clothes were wet, everything they had was wet.
bitterly cold. And when we played on the stage, you know, with these kind of hot air blowers keeping everyone warm. So it was, it was amazing.
So it was definitely a war zone. So when we flew in, it was daylight, and it looked like the day after an attack by the Viet Cong or something.
It turned so cold that, I mean to tell you, people were burning anything they could for warmth, for firewood and what have you. They were burning portlets and bleachers and just about anything that was combustible, they were burning.
I remember getting to the festival was quite fun, because we got in a helicopter. It was late at night. We flew over the Everglades with a searchlight underneath the helicopter, you know, shining down on this inky black water. We could see alligators flopping around in the water. And as we landed, another helicopter was landing. And out of that helicopter came the Jefferson airplane. And I'll never forget Spencer Dryden walking off the step and walking off this helicopter and going across the kind of causeway that he had to walk over to get to kind of dry land, as it were. And he fell in the water. He had to be dragged out of the water, soaking wet, you know, head to foot. Yeah, it was quite funny. We all laughed at him, of course, you know, being the cruel bastards that we are. But that was pretty funny, you know.
I said, some think it's your nose, some think it's your toes, I think it's your mind. I looked at him, I said, these are beautiful people. They're not really causing too much hassle. They're just being hassle.
An energetic citizens campaign and zoning board opposition failed to block this festival. Critics warned it will be an uncontrollable orgy. By Sunday, they and the rest of the community will know whether their worst fears came true.